Okay folks, it's follow-up video time again. Today with Black & Decker leaf vac and blower. What I'm going to try to do today is use this as a snow blower. See how this works. Quite snowy out here in Michigan. So, first I'm going to plug it in. So what you do is you take the cord, put a nice bend in it. Locks into place, and now you can leaf blow or snow blow without worrying about the cord coming out. Now keep in mind, this is water, even though it's frozen water. If it gets inside here, you can still have a possibility of a short circuit and maybe electrocution. So be careful with the cord when you're doing this. Make sure that there's no possibility of any water. I suppose we've got the power on high. Promising so far, huh? Working really well. So of course there's parts where snow kind of froze a little bit and then thawed and froze again, so I've got a little bit of crust here, but I find that I can use the mouth part to scrape and the crust comes off. So even in places where I've got little cat tracks, it's still possible to get the snow up even when it's stuck to when it's frozen. See this, but we've got this spot here where the snow is stepped on. For best results, you want to do this trick before any walking happens. This is the mailman. He came and crunched my snow down and it froze, so that's probably not going to come up. So try to do this before the snow gets walked on for best results. Now let's get my steps. So good. About this is you really, just like when you're leaf vacuuming, you don't want to, or leaf blowing, you don't want crud going inside this and getting inside the works. It's the same thing with snow. You don't want your snow to get sucked inside here and possibly cause problems inside the device. So be careful with that and try to keep your bottom end away from where the snow is flying. So far it's working pretty good. Can I keep it? though, you can really dig right down in there and get the snow out really well. So. That is, sometimes you get your car all covered with snow and you want to use a shovel or something to get it off, but you don't want to scratch your car. Even a broom can scratch your car sometimes. So let's see how this works for clearing snow off of my car. Try doing that with your snow blower. So after using it, you want to dry it off, of course. Don't let the water condense inside the motor, of all things. Check the bottom, make sure there's nothing encrusted. Turn it upside down and make sure there's nothing caught underneath the cover of the motor, so that there's nothing dripping inside. One other thing too is, you want to wear gloves when you're using this outside in the snow, because the wind coming through here is quite a wind chill effect on your hands, and I got myself a little uncomfortable, not frostbitten, but a little uncomfortable, and I had to stop and warm my hands up again. So be careful with that too when you're using this as a snow blower. Of course, you can't really just snow blow like a regular snow blower, but it works really good in spots where you got nooks and crannies to get into. Okay. After I'm using this, I set it pointed downward so that any water can drip away from the motor. Little bits of snow there. You should try to get those off as best as you can.